Hey guys, what's up? Jake the Ultimate here. Today I'm coming to you with a DCS tutorial. As you see, I got a Christmas shirt on. Not really, but I am recording this on Christmas Eve. So if I'm in a little bit of a mood, I'm excited for tomorrow. Because tomorrow is Christmas Day. And I have a lot of family coming and things like that. Anyways, let's get into the tutorial here. So in this video, I'm going to show you just like the basics of DCS, the basics of the F-22 Raptor. So F-22 A Raptor mod by, I don't want to pronounce it wrong, so I'm not going to say it. I'll leave the link to this download in the description, and I'll also make a separate video titling how to get this in the game, like files and all that. So as you see, the F-22, beautiful plane. First, we're going to need to go to our settings here, up here at the top, and then go ahead and click on system. No, I'm sorry, controls, not system, controls. Go up here, if it's not already on the F-22A, go ahead and select the F-22A. What you want to do is you're going to go down to access commands, and normally people would have something under their pitch. Now, it may seem like, oh, you know, you need pitch to control the plane. This add-on's a little bit weird, so you're going to have to go right-click right here and clear this combo, because you don't want to use this pitch. You want to use this F-22 FCS pitch axis. I know it sounds weird, but trust me, I figured this out the hard way, and it took quite a while. So, in your rolls, like, the tilt plane, like, in your rudder is, like, the wheel, basically what you use on the ground. Your thrust here, as you move that up and down, that controls the engines. Let's go ahead and go to countermeasures, because if you're in fights, you're always going to need these. So, I don't want to deploy chaff or flare separately, just put them all in one. So I have this button on my controller, I can just spam it, and then it'll deploy chaff and flares, depending if I have that in my plane or not. I'm going to go ahead and head over to sensors. And here's the main things you want. Radar on and off, because you're going to need a radar if you want to fire along Fox 3, or radar guided missile. Fox 3 is radar guided, Fox 2 is heat seeking. Fox 1s are really old, they don't use them nowadays, but they were like heat seeking missiles that relied on the mothership, aka the plane that fired, to keep lock on that plane and hit the target. So you're going to have this, you want this as a button. You also want this as a button, TWS, RWS. RWS is range will search. TWS means track will scan. I'll show you guys that in a minute after we get into the plane. So, you want display, zoom in, and display, zoom out for your radar. So, normally you start off 10 miles, 20 miles, 40 miles, 80 miles, and 160. You're going to need buttons to zoom in and out of those miles radius. Next, you want, don't worry about the zone scan, even though you may think it means like how to control your radar. You want the target designator down, left, right, and up. So you want to set those. You don't really need to worry about to center, because that doesn't really help. And you also, you want a button for target lock. That lets lock the target, your little crosshair on your radar is over. Sometimes when you do lock a target, you will have to go into, it spawns you in with RWS mode on. Sometimes you'll have to go to TWS to lock onto that target, and I will show you guys what those things look like after we're done with the settings. So now we have everything set in sensors. Let's go ahead and scroll down here. Now normally, if you go into view here, there's going to be something under, like, looking, and the automatic look button for me, like on my stick, my joystick, I don't like that as my view. I like it as my radar. So I just use my mouse to look, and I hope I get a VR headset tomorrow, because I've been begging my parents all year. So, and yes, this does support VR. So let's go back here, go to view, and just, I would say reset this, or if you like the view, and you want your radar something as different else, that's not that, then you can just leave it. But then go down here to weapons. So weapon change is going to be your changing from your Fox 3s to your Fox 2s. So changing from a radar guided missile to a heat seeking missile back and forth. Weapon fire, even though you think this means like you're basically you're firing the weapon, it actually means your gun. Okay, even though it may not sound like it, it means your gun. So you're gonna want that as your gun, and weapon release is like the missile fire button. So we're pretty much done with the settings here. Let's go ahead, I guess just load up. So I'll show you guys by just going into, just like how to start it up in a little flight, by going into our instant action, selecting our F-22A, and we can just do a ramp start so I can show you guys. Let me get my joystick. We have this little thing prototype where you can like sit on this part, so it's like between your legs joystick, which I think is pretty cool. My dad made it for me. Just wear pants when you're sitting on it. That's my only rule for it. So we're gonna go ahead and click fly here, and now we spawn the cockpit. I'm gonna go ahead and turn off the sound just because I feel like that might be distracting to you guys. So as you see, we are in the cockpit of the F-22. The first thing you want to do is come down to this corner, double click on your middle mouse button so you get this little crosshair. Go ahead and flip that battery switch on by left clicking. But you can't look around when you're in this mode. So you just go ahead and double click your mouse button again, your middle mouse button, then zoom in over here. And what you want to do is come over here and left click once, and then hold down left click. And then you'll hear like a noise, or if you don't have audio, just hold it down for about 10 seconds. And then when you think your APUs all started up, it should be on the arms position, which it is. Go ahead and flip these generators on, and you will see these screens turn on right here. Now, normally on a keyboard, if you want to start your engines, you press down right shift and the home button if you have a full-size keyboard. But if you don't, you can go into the settings, look for engine start, probably under the under this right here, and it should like say something about engines. Engines start, see, right shift and home. Engine stop, right shift end. But if you don't have the like home button on your keyboard, or right shift or whatever, you can change that to a combination that you like or have on your keyboard. So I'm gonna go ahead and press right shift. I already pressed right shift and home, as you see on this secondary flight display right here. Our engines are starting up. Make sure your throttle is back. I had it on for a sec. So go ahead, so my radar should start up when my engines are all started. And let's go ahead and close the canopy by clicking left control and C. So as you see, the canopy is now coming down. The canopy is in locked position. Alright, so now all my things are on, and in the middle right here, as you'll see, this screen is just like your primary flight display, and it's just on this, like, it just shows you this. Come down here and click this middle button that says RDR, that's your radar. Now, it may look a little, like, really weird. You can only activate it when you're in the air, so I'm going to have to take off and show you guys the radar. But our engines are all started up, and pretty much all you need to do if you want to, like, customize the display. So you want, like, your engines down here, for example, you can just go to, like, engines, just click that, and you want your bay right here. And then you want like that there. So it's very customizable, which I like about this add-on. So let's go ahead and start our taxi. Parking brake is automatically, let me check. Parking brake is automatically released. If you want to, you don't have to, just go ahead and landing light to taxi. And then let's go ahead, click our backslash button on the keyboard. If you don't have that, go under communications, because this toggles this menu at the top. We're gonna go ahead and click ATC. Click F1 always, because that is always automatically the airport you're at. And you probably should have requested startup before you actually started your engines. But they'll say, you know, blah, 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 it's fine. Let's go ahead and request taxi to our runway. And as you see, when I look around, I do have. So they're going to tell us at the top here, up here, what runway to go to. Taxi are only 4. Click F10 on your keyboard. Again, if you don't have it, you can switch to something else. And all we need to do is go left and then request takeoff. It's pretty easy. So I'm going to go ahead and add about 25% throttle. And then that'll get us moving. And let's use our rudder here to turn left. Rudder's pretty sensitive because it's a very highly maneuverable F-22. So be ready for like a big sensitive plane right here. So we're going to stop right before the runway. And W is your automatic set brake key, so just hold that down. It's not a toggle. I'm just going to line up with the runway since I didn't stop in time. I know it will probably make you cringe, but I'm not on the center line just because if I had like a buddy right here, we both have room to take off. So I'm going to go ahead. Nope, he just cleared me for takeoff. Sometimes it'll automatically clear you. Let's go ahead. Let's go about 85 throttle. And then when you're ready for afterburners, full throttle. And then when your speed gets up to about 120 knots, it'll automatically kind of start pulling you back. Just like come with it, work with it. And click G to put your gear up. And so I'm going to show you the radar. Click your radar on off button, as you see. And if you use your designator buttons, you can see it'll move around. Now, there's no targets in the air right now, so I can't show you, but I think there's some friendlies. I'll just lock onto them and shoot them, even though they're my friendlies. I really don't care. So, they're like right behind us. Very highly maneuverable plane. So they're like somewhere that way. Go ahead and click Q on your keyboard. That'll bring up that circle, which is like the radar mode, basically. And if you see a circle on target, that represents a friendly. So as you see here, we have a friendly. Now if I go ahead and click my target lock button, you'll see it has a box around it, which means it's a friendly. It has like the X in the box. So I'm just gonna go ahead and arm my weapons down here. Just go ahead and click that button, weapons armed, as you'll see. And just go ahead and hold your missile fire button. And bam, I just fired a Fox 3, which is a radar guided missile. And you should see like right here on your screen, it'll say like whatever plane you shot at, like F-22-A damaged or F-22-A destroyed, depending on what it was. So I just fired a missile at this guy. He is a friendly, and I am firing AIM-120Ds, which are the more long range variant of the AIM-120. So if you go into TWS mode, you can so just release your lock, and TWS mode actually tells you what altitude they're at and which way they're heading. But you may think, oh, TWS mode is the best. But the thing is, if you look here, see that's those two bottom circles moving around? That's basically the area it's scanning for. But if you're going just like scanning for people in general, you're gonna want to use RWS, which is like it uses this whole area. Can go up to 160 miles on both ends, TWS and RWS. And just press your that button. Is that missile coming from me? Even though it's, did he fire at me? Did my friendly fire at me? I'm gonna go ahead and defend here. Press my countermeasures button. I think my friendly fired at me because I fired at him. That's funny. See if I can lock him. He did fire an AIM-120D, which is the long-range variant of the AIM-120. I'm gonna go ahead. I got him locked here. I'm gonna go ahead and fly Ox 3. Did I fire? No, I didn't fire. Yeah, I did. So I'm gonna go ahead, and I think that'll be the end of the video for you guys. Thank you all so much for watching. Like, subscribe. Don't forget to click that notification bell, so you get notifications every time I post a new video or go live. And guys, Merry Christmas to all of you out there. And I hope this tutorial you find helpful. And the F-22, y'all know, is the best plane ever made.